Hello friends, how are you? I hope you all are good. Now in today's whatever our carbon and its compound, we are discussing what is the prefix. What beta? What is the prefix? So see, prior only we discussed what is the word root, then secondary suffix. Okay, so now we will discuss what is prefix. Okay, so see here, prefix means what? See, prefix is added before word root. See, prefix is added before what beta? Word root to indicate, so see here, to indicate side chain or substituent group present or substituent group present in the chain. Okay, present in the linear chain of molecule. Present in linear chain of molecule. Okay, so these are what beta? Prefix. So now we will discuss here what is the primary prefix and secondary prefix. Okay, so pay attention on this also. Primary prefix and secondary. So see here, small a we will discuss beta here. What? Primary. Yes, primary prefix. So primary prefix, in primary prefix, so see here, what beta? Cyclo. For example, if you are considering cyclo, so in primary prefix cyclo, because some compound that starting with cyclo prefix. Prefix means what? First. Okay, primary prefix. So see here, cyclo is used to differentiate cyclic compounds. Which compound beta? Cyclic compound. So see here, whatever your cyclic compounds are there, for that we have to use what? Cyclo as a prefix. For example, as you know, this what beta? Yes, this is what your cyclopropane. Yes, cyclopropane. Okay, then this what here? Yes, cyclobutane. Propane means what? Three carbon atom, 1 2 3. So here cyclobutane, 1 2 3 4. Okay, so like that we can write here. See here, this what beta? 1 2 3 4 5. So what? Cyclopentane. Understood? So we call it as a what? In primary prefix. Okay, so see here, what is the secondary? Okay, secondary prefix we will now discuss here. So for that, secondary prefix, very very much important here, whatever your secondary prefix. So see, in secondary prefix, okay, so see, it is regarded as substituent. What? Whatever secondary prefix is regarded as a what? Substituent. And we call it as a what beta? Secondary prefix. So whatever is secondary prefix, so we can now differentiate. Okay, so we will start to differentiate that secondary prefix also. So start. So see here, suppose we will write here beta. Yes, group. Okay, group, then here what? Secondary prefix. Secondary prefix. Okay, so see here, group means what? As you know beta, fluoro, chloro, bromo, iodo, these are what? Yes, we can write here fluoro, chloro, bromo, iodo, these are what? We can call it as a what beta? Secondary prefix. We can write here fluoro, chloro, yes, bromo, then what beta? Iodo, these are what? Secondary prefix. Okay, so see here,
whenever we are discussing about this prefix, so here most of the thing, that is your, say here we can write another example also, bond NO2, so we call it as a what, beta, nitro. Okay, in some aliphatic compound nitro also there. Okay, so see here, some compound C6H5, so we call it as a what, beta, phenyl. Okay, next, as you know, beta, see, bond CH3, so we call it as a what, beta, methyl. These are at a what, secondary prefix only, CH3, CH2, CH3, we can call it as a what, ethyl. Okay, now see here, beta, bond CH2, CH2, CH3, so these are what called propyl. Understood? Means when one of the hydrogen is replaced by your alkyl group, so these are what, capital R only. Okay, we discuss in derivatives of hydrocarbon. Okay, understood? These are what, capital R only, means one of the hydrogen is replaced, so we call it as a what, vinyl. Ethyl, then ethane is converted into ethyl, methane is converted into methyl. Okay, so like this here. Now see here, beta, isopropyl also there. How, see, bond CH, CH3 and CH3. So we call it as a what? Iso, see here, iso in middle, iso. Propyl, propyl means what, total carbon atom 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, now see here, we can write here secondary butyl also. See, like this, CH3, CH bond, CH2 and CH3, see, at the second position, so we call it the what, secondary butyl, or we can say sec butyl. Okay, we can write as isobutyl also. So see here, iso bond CH2, CH, CH3 and CH3, so see, each carbon atom is valence. Okay, so see here, these are what we call it, the isobutyl. Okay, so these are very, very much important, your secondary what, secondary prefix. Okay, few more also there, tertiary butyl also there. Okay, so see here, whatever tertiary also we can write here. Okay, so we will write here tertiary butyl also. So see here, I will write here tertiary butyl, CH3, 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 these are what? Yes, tertiary butyl. Tertiary butyl, but means what? 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so this thing is very, very much important here. Whatever your groups and whatever your secondary prefix. Okay, this also you can write downside. Okay, these are what, beta, secondary prefix. Now we will discuss most important thing in whatever our IUPAC names. Okay, so see your IUPAC names. Okay, so see here, in IUPAC names, rules for IUPAC nomenclature of ionic organic compounds. So see here, rules, say here, rules for IUPAC nomenclature of what, beta, organic compounds. Organic compounds. Okay, so see here, rules for IUPAC nomenclature of an organic compound. First rule, so pay attention here, whatever first rule you have to write one by one, okay, in your notebook. Rules for organic compound for IUPAC nomenclature. First, longest chain rule. What, beta, first? Yes, longest chain rule. So see here, in longest chain rule, what we are to find here in longest chain rule? First, beta, select first If any organic compound is there, your straight chain, branch chain, aliphatic carbon atom. So you have to, your first duty is what? To select longest chain. Select chain of carbon atom. So see here, you have to write select chain of carbon, select chain of carbon atom, okay, containing maximum number of, containing, yes beta, containing maximum, okay, so containing maximum number of what? Yes, carbon atoms, okay, maximum number of carbon atoms, and if possible, okay, and if possible, maximum number of functional group like C double bond C and whatever, if functional group is present, then you have to start numbering from that functional group, okay. Suppose your alkene, then alkyne, then acid, aldehyde, these functional groups are present. So you have to start with that functional group. Okay, so see here, we will see example beta, how we can select longest chain. Okay, it is very much important part. Say here, we will discuss one of the important whatever example. Okay, so as like this your example, suppose, okay, CH2 and CH3. So first here, you have to select first longest chain. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, you select this longest chain, okay, then you have to start numbering. So first is rule what? You have to select longest chain. Okay, suppose I will write like this, another example. Okay, so whatever naming part, so we will also do here naming part also and whatever numbering part. So in that next rule, it will automatically come here, whatever your next rule, how numbering will occur and what is the name of this organic compound. So see here, you have to numbering if from this side. Why? Because whatever this substituent, that also you will get what? Minimum number, lowest number. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, so total 6 carbon atom chain, understood. So I did 3 position your substituent. So beta, prefix, so see a substituent, what will be in the name of above organic compound? So see, 3-methyl, yes, yes, 3 is what your methyl. So 3-methyl what? Hexane, understood, 3-methyl hexane. Okay, means you have to select longest chain here. Okay, suppose we will discuss beta another example. Suppose these are what your first and second, we will discuss here. Okay, so see here what they give. Okay, see, we will discuss CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2. Okay, say then what beta here? CH3, then here what? CH2, CH2 and CH3. Okay, so in this and such compound, we have to select beta what? Yes, longest chain you have to select. Well, then how it will select? So see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, now we will discuss, say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So what is our rule? You have to select first longest chain. Okay, so it will like this here. So which we have to preferred like this. Okay, so see here, understood. Say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Suppose if you are counting this, so how much here? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only. This is longest, 8 carbon atom. Now simply we have to do what? Numbering. Okay, so say here, beta, 1, 2, then these are what? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and what? 8. Okay, now we can write here name also of this IUPAC nomenclature, whatever your organic compound. Yes, easy, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 4, yes. I did 4 position here substituent. So what will be the name? 4-methyl octane. Because these are what? All are singly bonded, means A-N-E. That's why what? Octane, A-N-E. So see here, we have to write, we can write your name. What beta? 4-methyl, yes or no? Means whatever you substitute also you will get. Minimum number, lowest number. Okay, that we are going to discuss in next rule. But I am a basic thing. Okay, you pay attention on that. So see 1, 2, 3, 4. 4-methyl octane, because these are parent genomic carbon atom. A, that's why what? Octane. 4-methyl what? Octane. A-N-E. Why A-N-E? Because all are singly bonded. So here also what? All are your singly bonded. Okay, understood. Now these are what? First, select longest chain rule. In that I discuss what? Whatever numbering part and whatever organic IUPAC nomenclature part also I discuss. Okay, so we will now discuss whatever our second rule for naming organic compounds. Okay, so ready for this? See here, second rules for larger number of side chain. What beta? Rules for, okay, say here, second rules for larger number of what beta? Side chains. Okay, larger number of side chain means here you have to write first this. If two chains of equal length, if two chains of equal length, okay, if two chains of equal length are possible, then select one with larger number of side chain. Then select, okay, then select the one with what? Largest number of what? Largest number of side chain. Side chains. Okay. So whatever, if two chains of equal length then are possible, then select the one with largest number of side chains. So see here, what we have to see here, in that we will discuss with example. So see here, with example, what we have to write beta. See, suppose this example, they give CH3CH, then here what beta? CH3. Okay, then here also what they give? CH2 CH3. Okay, CH2 CH2 and CH3. Okay, suppose this compound they give. Okay, so here beta, see, whatever, if two chains are of equal length, then wherever largest number of side chain or substituents are present, that you have to select. Okay, so see here, if you are considering this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, suppose if you select this, okay, if you select this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, so suppose we will do the numbering also. Okay, so see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and what 6. Okay, and suppose same compound I will write here again. So see here, CH3 CH CH3 CH CH2 CH3 CH2 CH2 and what beta CH3. Okay, now if you are counting like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or it is also here, what beta? Understood? Or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, suppose we will consider like this chain, but we have to select like whatever longest chain. In that, we got maximum number of side chain or substituent we will get. Means here, if you are counting like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So these are, we will get one only substituent. Okay, but here if you count like this, then you will get what, two substituent, methyl and ethyl. Okay, so in that question will arise. Okay, what bit of question will arise? Wherever numbering start from this carbamidum or this carbamidum. Okay, so it is easy. Why? See here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 6 carbamidum chain. And number here to whatever substituent. So as you know, beta, whatever this is what? Say, whatever this, this we call it as a what? Methyl. Okay, and this we call it as a what? Ethyl. Okay, then at that time we have to give whatever name alphabetically order. Okay, in alphabetical order. Okay, so these are what? If two chains of equal lengths are possible, then select number with a larger number of side chains. So see, larger number of side chains, or you can say what? Substituent. Okay, so these are what, beta? Yes, these are your second rule. Rules for larger number of side chain, or we can say what? Substituent. Okay, so see here, third, whatever third we are going to discussing here, third part, lowest locant rule. Okay, third rule we are going to discuss, lowest locant rule. Or we can say what? Lowest sum rule. What, beta? Or we can say lowest sum rule. Okay, so very, very much important is also lowest locant rule, lowest what? Sum rule. Okay, so pay attention on this also. See here, very much interesting this also. If the parent chain of carbamidum is numbered in a such way that the sum of position of side chain should be minimum. So whatever sum of positions of side chain, it must be, or we can say whatever sum of positions of that substituent must be what? Minimum. Okay. So, and as you know, if whatever your alkene and alkyne is present, so you first give preference to alkene first, then what? Why? That is alkyne. Okay. So, we will what discuss here one example. Okay, so see here, we will discuss here one example. Lowest locant rule or lowest sum rule, very, very much important and interesting. Okay, so see here, beta, we can start with example. Okay, so see, they gave first year examples, CH3, CH2, C, CH3, and here what also, CH3. Here they gave us CH3, okay. Then here what, beta? CH2 and CH3. Okay, so no doubt, beta, here you have to select first longest chain, then maximum number of substituent also. Okay, like that you have to select chain. Yes, obviously 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so numbering here, most of the important part is what? Numbering. Okay, so see here, first select, we will select first longest chain without wasting time. Okay, we select. Now, if you are thinking, you are numbering from this side or this side. So, we can now check numbering here from both the sides. Ready? See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And suppose if you start numbering from this side, so what will be the position, sum of that position of your substituent? Okay, so see here, beta, 3 plus 4 plus 4. Why 4 plus 4? Because at D4, methyl group, and now here also methyl group. That's why what, beta? 4 plus 4. So how much it will total here? Yes, 11. Okay, and suppose I will start numbering beta from this side 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. Okay, so what will happen? Okay, so see here, whatever that sum of substituent positions of, okay, so see here beta, 3 plus 3 plus 4, in that carbon only your substituents are present. Okay, so how much it will come? 10. So among these two, which one is lowest? As you know, 10 is lowest. So which numbering we have to prefer here? Yes, this numbering we have to prefer from left to right. Okay, so what will be the IUPAC nomenclature of this organic compound? Very much easy. Yes, 3 substituent we have to prefixes, secondary prefixes you have to give the number. So 3, 3, 4, in case of 2 or more than 2 substituents are present of same alkyl group, so we have to write what, di, tri, tetra, according to number of that substituents. Okay, so 3, 3, 4, trimethyl, yes or no? See, 1, 2 and 3 methyl are there, at the position also mentioned. 3, 3, 4, trimethyl what? Hexane. Okay, I hope you understood this. Okay, so now beta, we will discuss here one more also. Yes, we can. Ready? See here, we can discuss one more also. Example here. Okay, so as I told already here, okay, we will discuss that also. CH2 double bond, next example we will discuss beta. Second here, this CH2 double bond, CH, okay. Then here what? CH2, C triple bond, CH. Suppose like this compound, it will came in your exam. So what? In the case of double and triple bond, you have to prefer first double bond, then after triple bond. Why? Because alphabetically, ENE from double bond, it will come first. Okay, so you have to give numbering in this fashion. From this carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and what beta 6. Understood or not? You have to give number of only carbon atom, carbon chain. Okay, so what will be the name of this compound, whatever organic compound here? Yes, hex. We have to write, we have to mention position of the double bond and triple bond also. Okay, you have to mention position of double and triple bond also. So be careful. Hex one in. After that what beta? Hex one in. Then what? 5-YNE. 5-YNE means what? Triple bond. So we gave here IUPAC the nomenclature for this organic compound. Okay, understood or not? Okay, so whatever these are what some rules, so whatever next rules we will discuss in our next lecture. I hope you understood all this whatever we discuss in this lecture. Okay, so Veda, take care, stay safe and stay home. If you have any doubts, you can feel free to ask on WhatsApp. Thank you very much.